using MRD in any kind of molecular assay, we first of all have to define the landscape of the respective leukemia cells of the patient at diagnosis. And doing this, we, over the last 15 to 20 years, experienced a huge number of genes that were found out to be of importance in AML. For pathobiology of the disease, for prognosis and prognostication, and even for specific targets for treatment. So today, the state of the art to define these respective genes that are giving all this information at diagnosis and open up the field for MRD in the respective patient, with or without allogeneic transplantation, is nearly based in all cases and should be based on a technique called next generation sequencing, NGS. And with this technique, we now have in our hands the option to investigate at diagnosis not one gene or two or five, but 10 or 50 or 80 genes in one run. Even an exome or a genome would be possible, what is today not routine, it's research. But if we go at the time point of diagnosis, and let's say we investigate 80 genes of interest from which we know they play an important role for the diagnosis, for the classification according to WHO, what is in many cases now based on chromosomes or genes or fusion genes, then we, in one run, can multiplex a lot of patients for a lot of genes. And the turnaround time that is now able to achieve in a routine setting is below a week, even within 2 days. So that means that for some genes that may be very important right after the beginning, for the first hit of treatment, we can, let's say, wait 2 or 3 days before we have this information, and then according to this, start with a targeted treatment approach. For example, in FLT3 ITD mutations or in the APL, this is one of the most important aspects where we pick up a specific fusion gene and start with a precision medicine drug.